is such a beautiful day outside, I thought let's do a fall tour and show you guys my home for fall 2019. Come on in. So the first thing that you see when you walk in my door is my Halloween display right up here at the front. I love a grand entrance, honey, and when you walk in the door, I want it to be spectacular and catch your eye. So let me show you some of the things that I've got here at my door to really make it pop. I started with a simple mirror. I like to take things from my everyday life, such as my mirror and my piece of furniture here, and leave those things. I ain't going out, honey, and spending a fortune. I like to use things that are already in place. So what I did is I took a decorative fall wreath, which I made, honey, designs by Dylan on Facebook, and just hung that with a wreath hanger on my mirror just to kind of set the tone. Once I had the wreath there, then I continued. I added an arrangement. I used some decorative pieces such as the fun little jack-o'-lantern. I don't like scary, but I did go see it too. Have y'all seen that? And I put a little fun scarecrow. And then one of my favorite things to do is take placemats because they're so inexpensive and you can put them everywhere, not just on your table. So I put them down here at the bottom. I put lots of decor on them. I put glassware, some Flitz and Floyd, all kinds of stuff, girl. So this kind of wraps up my entryway. And to really top it off, I love Halloween people. I mean, that didn't even make sense, but I love these little Halloween things that I got a few years ago. I used to put them outside, but this year I put them indoors. So you're gonna see how I can take them and I kind of offset this piece of furniture with those pieces and with some spooky Halloween trees. So moving on from my front door, my entryway, we bring you right up in here to the living room, girl. And what better thing to set off and make a great statement for your living room other than your mantle? So if you guys did not check it out already, go back to my video tab and check out my past videos of one, my front door demonstration, and you'll get to see how I did this beautiful mantle from start to finish. But some of the things that I love to incorporate in my fall decor is glitter. You can repurpose your Christmas stems, you can repurpose your Mardi Gras stems, and use colors that coordinate well with your fall or Halloween decor. So girl, I pulled out the good old lime green, a little bit of gold, a little bit of copper, and I mixed all of those things into my garland. I even took some rooster feathers. No, I didn't kill a rooster. I popped those in there, and leopard. Leopard was my main color this year. You probably saw that on my last video at the front door, and you saw it in my mantle video. So here it is today. It really blends well with all of the feathers, the berries, the fall foliage, and to give myself some great length on this bad boy, I've added just this fabulous greenery garland. Now, Josh said it looks like weeds, but I don't really care what he thinks. So this is some weeds, honey, hanging down from the garland, but hey, it added some great length onto the base of my mantle here. Another great way to really accent or set off your mantle, kind of balance it out, I love to take decorative signs. I love Hocus Pocus. Have you guys seen that movie? If you haven't, something is wrong, but y'all leave a comment down below and let me know. But I love Hocus Pocus. It's my favorite movie, and I knew this year when I saw that sign, I had to get it. So I added that on my mantle, and I also, in my monthly design group, Dylan's Divas, showed my divas how to take a plaque and really embellish it and incorporate lots of florals, glitter, and fun components such as ribbon to really make that pop as well. So on my mantle this year, you'll notice I have two different signs, one with foliage and then one without, to really balance each other. So for anybody who knows me, y'all know I'm obsessed with Department 56 and Christmas villages. Wait till my Christmas videos, guys. I'm gonna have so many villages in here, I'm probably gonna blow a breaker. But I have a Halloween village this year. I don't have many pieces, but I like to put a few up to kind of set the tone. And I like to take Halloween and fall pieces and kind of display them throughout my home to really just kind of get a little bit of that fall touch everywhere that you look. So you're gonna see above my washer and dryer this year that I took a few pieces of my village and really just made a great little display to kind of set the tone of Halloween over there on the other side of the house. So now that we have finished the interior of my fall home tour, honey, let's talk about first impressions. Speaking of first impressions, that is why I cannot go to a drive-thru. You know, I look in that window, see them dirty nails, ugh, I'm done. So, but let's talk about first impressions from the street, okay? You want to have a beautiful exterior, just like the interior, girl. So we did my front door, which you can find on one of my past YouTube videos, but I also have added some other things. But let's talk about why I chose the colors that I did. So I wanted to carry out the theme throughout my home. That's why my mantle, it kind of resembles what you see here behind me. So I love those rooster feathers. I love leopard. I love lime green. Again, I love to bring in metallics that I can repurpose from other seasons to really make my door and my decor pop. One of my other things that I love this year is, of course, ornaments. Another repurposed item. And I love to use these velvet pumpkins. They are bigger than ever. God, didn't I y'all pay attention? This is Peter, honey. I picked him up yesterday. Shout out to Target. And I just love him. So speaking of exterior decor, guys, I also wanted to talk to you about garlands. Garlands are not just for your front door or your mantle or banister. They can also be used to accent your windows. If you're like me, I have a small porch on the front of my house, and I love to accent and bring just the fun seasonal colors from time to time. So what I did this year is I took a 9-foot garland, I designed it in my monthly design group, and I really just accented this window. Again, that set the tone for my whole porch. Then I took my pre-existing table. How you doing, Peter? This is Peter. I brought Peter out here. I brought some decorative scarecrows that were inexpensive. And to really just set this whole thing off, I brought out some orange Halloween trees that illuminate and light up at night and bring out the orange lights that I have in both my window garland, my door garland, and of course, my mantle garland. Well, I hope you all enjoyed my fall home tour. Girl, I cannot wait to show you my Christmas now that this tour and this filming is done. Goodbye, fall, okay? Philip knows I'm about to take all this down and we are gonna get started on Christmas. I know it's early. Early, but girl, you gotta start early. New content and material. Oh my God, the dog. Stella, what are you doing? Hey, tell you guys again. That's a good blooper. On today's video, I'm gonna show you all around my home and all of my tricks and goodies. That sounded stupid. Okay, we're gonna start over. No, you're not in the video. You're not in the video. Get out. Oh, you ready to film? I'm sorry. I also give you one produced pre-recorded tutorial per month as an exclusive. What in the heck? That just screwed that up. I also give you a pre-recorded produced tutorial. What is going on today with these dogs? They're all over, vultures. Okay, get down. I can also give you a pre-recorded. No.